We are on the second series of this lecture on the about science and faith, no?
May mga apekto.
So, let me lead you to our special, not common topic. We'll talk about the dinosaurs and now the question is, if we're talking about dinosaur, have anybody seen a dinosaur? Mag-quiz ko sa mga young people. Naabay tao sa unang-unang panahon nga nakakita og dinosaur? Ha? Nakakita ka? Sa libro. Wala'y nakakita. So if that's the case, that would contradict the Bible. Kasi everything was created man in 6 days. And the land dinosaurs were created on the same day where Adam was created, on the 6th day. 4th day, I think it was on the 3rd day na nag-create ang mga water, mga isda o mga ano. And naabay dinosaur nga gimension sa Biblia? Wala po, no? So, di na tayo padayon nito, ano istorya-istorya mga dinosaur? Now, if there's 2 questions, you answer yes, na nakakita, nasa Bible lang ano, na ay dinosaur, would dinosaur fit in the ark? So, murag no, yung tanan yung answer. Ha? Nasa libro, wala sa Biblia. So, this is more interesting. This is actually a big challenge. And according to your answer, murag di yun mao ang nakauna sa Biblia. And we will continue to learn more. Because of this, kana ganing teaching of evolution of the billions of years, the theologists, in fact, created a new theory para to fit in what is sa the science of evolution to our theology. Unsa tawag na, muna itawag of gap theory. Unsa gihimo nila, between the Genesis 1:1 and Genesis 1:2, which is gingon din sa Genesis 1:1, if you can read, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And in verse 2, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the earth. So, gingon diha nga, between that time, na ay billions of years where God created the dinosaurs. And did God destroy it? That is why, walay form and void. And you know, this kind of theory has no basis. Gihimo lang ni para mo fit in ang atong theology sa science. Is it good? Kung if you were here last time sa topic na to nga, the scientific accuracy of the Bible, wherein ang Bible jud ang dominant, o kanang siya ang mas ano kasi, it was there in the Bible before it was discovered by men. We don't need to change our point of view to fit in with the science nga gihimo sa mga un-Christian para mag-fit in. That is why na-create ni siya. And in fact, if you remember, those who were here 9 years ago, I also delivered this message. After my message, a pastor stood up. Atotong timbang-timbangon ang gisulti kay murag wala na sa among natunan sa Bible school. And I hope kanang wala na mo tindog din niya. Let's continue. Kay challenging magyo kay ini kay dili magoto pwede makambyo ang nasab sa Biblia. Masipag kusa na sa nga scientist. Ingon dinhi. Okay? Gamay kayo. In Genesis 1:21, then God said, "Let the oceans swarm with living creatures and let the flying creatures soar above the earth throughout the sky." It's talking about the fish, the fishes and the birds, including also the flying reptiles, which are we call now as dinosaurs, okay, and the dinosaurs in the sea. And then in Genesis 1:24, and God said, "Let the earth bring forth each kind of livestock and crawling thing, and each kind of earth's animal." And that's what happened. Or that happened on the 6th day before God created Eve and Adam on the 6th day. And on the 7th day, usa ni tabo, God rested. Ganon, gikapoy di ang Ginoo. Not necessarily ana. But it just means God rested. Okay? And when since wala na ilain na creation sa within the 6th day, It was there. Kung na may dinosaur, it was there. Na itao, it was there. And they saw it. Okay. Ang isa ka problema with the gap theory is yung inang-inang believe that dinosaurs killed, God killed all dinosaurs before He created man is would contradict the Bible because before sin, there was no death. Before sin, there was no death. Mga na kung wala pa nakasala si Adam and Eve, we believe nga, they will live, still live. But because of sin, death came to us. Na natin kamatayon. Okay? Kaya nga, it would contradict katong gingon. Ingon din sa Exodus 20:11, "For in 6 days the Lord made the heaven and the earth and sea and all that in them is." In the 6 days. And some would argue nga, Brother Bone, kanang 6 days, dili man na literal nga 1 day. That will be 1,000 days, and I think they quote it from, okay, wala, na, but I, somewhere, I think you're familiar that a day is like 1,000 days to the Lord. They would quote that. Pero kung inyong basahon, dili man siya is, a 1 day is 1,000 words, but one day is like 1,000 words. And it's referring to those nga promise about God nga don't be kuan. Pwede nga nag-promise yung Ginoo, it will happen because sa katuwa, we count days, but sometimes God, we count thousands of days. It is not saying that 1 day is equivalent to thousands of years. And now we conflict, ana. Kung gihimo sa Ginoo ang mga tanom on the 4th day, and the sun and the moon on the 5th day, if 1 day is equivalent to thousands of years, dili mabuhi ang mga tanom, ang mga ano, kung hulat pata ang 5th day, 1,000 years, mamatay kay walay sun. But 1 day ang ano, it will ano, and we'll have a detail on this, just to change, especially sa young people. Ayan people, manggod ka ng naghahangyo nga, kung naa sila yung service kay wag din sila kasakay, or di na mag-grasp ang mga topic ni, but, mo na ni, no? This is for you actually. Ikay mo kay naapo mo sa eskulahan, try to take note on this because that is very important. Okay? Kani mga lies na gikuan sa... So, let's talk first about dinosaurs. That dinosaurs is very fascinating ng topic. I like dinosaurs. I love to watch movies that has dinosaurs on it. Like kaning Jurassic Park. Ako nang nahurutan nga series sa Jurassic Park. The question is, okay, wala na daw karon. Kani, sa National Geographic, first sentence of this article is ingon, "No human being has ever seen a live dinosaur." Sa ato nabasa kini ha, wala ba kakita si Adam o Eve o dinosaur kung gihimo man sa Ginoo ang dinosaur? Medyo dugay-dugay pag-aigahi pa ito pandaron. Sige, let's continue. Okay? So, use this U-Guide page to help capture the interest of young readers and stimulate the discussion with them. So this is the kind of art I showed to my students 2 weeks ago. In 1571, yung kanyang mga Spanish, mahilig man mo-conquer og land, and they will bring with them artifacts back to Europe, to Spain. But this happened in 1571. Kasi Nadia, this is called the Inca Ceremonial Burial Stone, wherein sa bato, nga dagkong bato, they will etch not an image of anything, and makita natin din ni R. Kung saan niyo ma-recognize? Brachiosaurus, T-Rex, Triceratops, Stegodon. These are all dinosaurs and these are in 1571. Now, kung saan ma-interesting, ana? Okay, let's... Okay, may ano lang ko. Ang dinosaur manggod na discovered in 1800s, 1881, no, by Dr. Mandel, and the first dinosaur was Iguanodon. So before 1881, nobody knows, nobody was able to read in the books nga sasing as these big lizards. But these people, prehistoric ha, wala pa na-invento ang sulat, naana sila product ani nga very accurate, mura pong nakakita sila og movie, mura nakakita sila og libro, nga tama kay pagka-portray nga sa T-Rex, sa Brachiosaurus, no? Triceratops. It is not possible nga they do it from their imagination. And again, one of my students also, Sir, peke mo na lang, sir. Pwede mo na lang sa mukuan. Well, nain nagapeke. But you know, pila ka buong inani? Pila ka buong inani nga ano? Isa sa tao dito nga nagakolect, si Dr. Javier, he owned 11,000 of this collection no in Peru. In Inca. Naa siya collection of this and all na-discovered mo ni during a flood na unearthed ang katuuna uncover ang katong cave kasi kung mo ni ka ng ceremonial burial stone nga pag naimamatay ilubong tong appeal sa ilaha part sa ilang kultura and naa 50,000 of this who would fake 50,000 of this stone just to kana ipeke lang kung naa ni kadaghan it would only mean that this is part of their culture. Kana usually ginahimo nila and then pagaman ibutang sa ilang ano as part of the burial furnitures. And you can see some samples of other stones like this. Asa matong ano ani? Okay? Part of this stone nga gisakyan pagtao, ang adreso nagigaway sa tao, napo di na kay maklaro sa kanang drapery sa cloth nga gibender na sa jar. And these are in the Inca civilization of all of these animals that could be because they lived together long ago. Now, the question now is, pwede ba mag-survive ang ano? Now, with the question is, was the word dinosaur in the Bible? Why don't I find the word dinosaur in the Bible? It's because, yung nga, the word dinosaurs was only invented in 1841. After the discovery of Iguanodon, daghan na bang discovery, madagko kay mga lizard nga, wala na to na-recognize, ka-giant yun siya. And that's the time, they gave the word, they invented the word, dinosaur in 1841, no? And, but in the Bible, was written in 1611, ang tawag nila ani is tanin. Or dragons. Okay? Tanin or dragons. Kani, in 1822, moni ang discovery of Iguanodon, moni ang forma sa Iguanodon. And then in 1841, naanay 9 types of these different reptiles. So it was Dr. Owen who gave the word Dinosauria, meaning terrible lizard. Okay, butiki. Giant butiki. No? So, ay gamay kayo, but I'll just read it to you. The name and date of the first written in the Bible, kaning tanin or dragon, written between 1400 BC, and the behemoth is before 1400 BC. The word dinosaurs only, after nasulat na ang Biblia, ang first translation, ang King James, even the Leviathan, you have heard about this. But the word dinosaurs was only 1841, we call it dinosaur. It could be the behemoth, could be the brachiosaurus, or the Leviathan, would be the conosaurus. That was discovered only in 1900. Here, kasi nasa, ang akong field magod, art history. Kaya may hili ko mga artifacts. Ako po nagipakita sila, ha. This is a palette of King Narmer, the first pharaoh in Egypt. Egypt before was divided into two kingdoms, na ay upper or lower kingdoms. But come this time, nga mas powerful ning sa upper kingdom, no? Iyaning nakuha ang lower kingdom and Egypt became one nation. And because of that victory, he made a murag trophy ba, no? Palette. Makita na to the people, no? Usually, ang mga Egyptian art, ang mga more important people are bigger. Dili na sila giant, ha? So, kani mga lesser important, these are the slaves, no? Ang pharaoh maybe I think this is the pharaoh but kung maka na pa sila og ilang gas mas dako pag yun na we can recognize the animal here no karabaw o buffalo and other animals but what is this taas og liog taas og kanang kuan it is not giraffe kasi ang ikog sa giraffe dili man dako gamay man in Queensland Australia so these are in different places these are just sample na of the pictures that I will show you. So, in Queensland, Australia, they have this drawing nga gipalibutan sa mga tao, sa mga aborigines, the original people in Australia. And may mga story about this Yaru and Yarba, patawag nila. O kaninga picture nga, kaninga dako kayo nga creature, and we know that it's located in the water, no? Water-dwelling animal. And the people there are encircling the animal, holding weapons. It means they are hunting these animals. Ginapakita pa nga ni ang intestine, but pasabot ilan ni gibutcher, maybe for food consumption. Okay? Kani also in 1945 sa Mexico, na ay around 33,000 of these no, kani pre-classical Chupacuaro culture. No? O makita na ito din nga ang ilang, ang paghahimo diha, kaysa ka ng active, dili ka ng posing lang ang magpaporte, but interactive ba? Agile, no? Kanang nagalihok. So, it's a good evidence that they kanang observe. So, why would people put dinosaurs on their artwork if they have not seen the real ones? I think the big question with us, kaya ba mag-survive ang tao with a dinosaur? You know, the biggest animal in the world actually is not the dinosaur. It's not the teres. Sa picture, unsa man siya? Whale. It is the blue whale. Okay? Ang T-Rex, ano lang kadako, more a little bigger than elephant. This is the giraffe. And this is the biggest dinosaur. Actually, this is a herbivorous, di na mukha og tao. But the biggest animal actually is the whale. And because whale is living in the sea, ang natural habitat niya is in the sea, it is almost impossible to hunt them. Kung mag-away mi sa blue whale, sa yuta, ako ang natural habitat, musukol ko sa iyaha. Yuta man, no, maganda na siya, di yun ang kasukol sa kuha. Pero kung dito may mag-away sa dagat, isa lang kahapak sa iyang ikog, sa akong baruto o boat, wala, taob na yun ko. But you know, kaning species is already endangered. Kay maumuni ang ginausog, ginahunt siya for the oil, na kusog sa una, ginapang pantambal, pang ano sa suga, katong panahon na that karon is already almost to extension. But karon kining T-Rex, kaya makain na, mamuna ginapalabas sa mga movie nga, di siya, lisod siya patsyon, actually. One, now, natay quiz na po din eh. These are the bath, okay? Kita ninyo, kaning mga paniki, talinis o kaning kuan. Among the six, only one is a carnivorous. Can you guess? Asa niya? Di mahibawan, no? Di mahibawan. Oh, na yung makaguess, tagaan na itong prize. Trip to Jurassic Park. Kana. Because, what I'm saying is, it doesn't mean nga talinis yung mungipon o tagas, carnivorous ka na. These are plant eaters. Okay? What about the T-Rex? Okay, T-Rex. So, T-Rex. Oh. Sa Jurassic Park, patinda ko, actually, ka ng mga movie, gina-exaggerate na, diyan yung anak kadako. This is actually the actual size of the head of the T-Rex. I was there. I encountered the T-Rex. When we were in Japan in 2005, na ato sa Natural History of Museum, tagas yun siya o ganang ngipon. Talinis yun, 6 inches good. But the problem of this animal is, kung 6 inches ang iyang gawas, kumukaon siya o mupaak siya o karne, ang iyang magong lubong sa iyang gums is only 1 inch. Oh, kasi mga dental anak. Pag mukaon siya, gahi nga ka ng karne, mabili na ang iyang ngipon. Sa tuwa gani, pag kani atong ngipon, kung siya gawas, maupunin ka dako o mas bigger pa sa ang ugat. Kung yun yung igon, parang teres ana, ang ilang anak lang kababaw ang ilang lubong sa iyang gums. They cannot eat meat. Kumulubong mo ng 6 inches nga, no, dili, mabili na siya. Okay, isa pa. Another is, kanang T-Rex, kung iyo mo tanaw niyang lawas mo sa elepante, bugat yun siya, dago kayo siya og legs. Pero ang kanang yang kamot sa tubangan, gamay kayo. Impa kung imo rin itong birahon, mabali na eh. Dili na kagunit og prey. And if ever, kaninga dinosaur, mudagan, naging mo sa simulation, naging mo sa robot, kung mudagan siya paspas, kung predator yun siya nga, as in the movie is showing, nga kusugi mudagan, and then mo break suddenly, o siya may tabo, mamuligid, mabuak ang ulo. Nana silang simulation. Another thing is, ang T-Rex is a bipodial animal standing only in 2 legs. And it is very easy to kill them. Ano sa man? tusukon lang ang kasing-kasing. Na, rah, tak, Pero sa mga movie nga, dugay kay sa patyon, ala, no, pila ka, tangki di gira. Ngano di man nila tusukon ang kasing-kasing, open man kayo. It is even harder to kill an elephant. Kaya baga mag-una sila mga panit, ang elepante, ang kasing-kasing, wala na-expose. Ang mga pygmies sa Africa, ana sila maghantong elepante, they have to disable the three legs. So, ang tirahan nila, ang dili na masigtira sa labas, kaya baga kayo nagpanit, ang tirahan nila ang kanang tiil, pag ma-disable lang tiil, matumba, pag open na sa kanila, tusukon na kasing-kasing. Ang target is the heart. Terex is open. Isa ka shotgun lang na, kwan na, extinct na siya, no? Babay Terex. Now, in the Bible, okay, let's go to the Bible. Genesis 1:29-30. And God said, "Behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree in which is the fruit of the tree yielding seed to you shall be for meat." 30. And to every beast, ang 21 is talking about, this is actually the commandment sa Adam and Eve. Ang imong kaunon, sige na kundin, mukaon ka og herb. Fruit of the tree. Okay? To you shall be meat. Dili pwede mukaon siya og animal because wala pa yun ang death before sin. Okay? Verse 30, unsay commandment dyan sa mga hayop. And to every beast of the earth, kasi mga beast, mga hayop. And to every fowl of the air, mga langgam. And to everything that creepeth upon the earth wherein there is life, I have given every green herb for meat, and it was so. Tanan nga hayop, that would include the dinosaurs. Dili sila pwede mukhaon o kapwa nga dinosaur, kapwa hayop, or even man. That is why Adam and Eve, they can name these animals, pwede niya sakyan-sakyan, because they can live in harmony. Wala pa'y pwede mukhaon. Even if that is the commandment of God, I believe wala pa'y appetite nga maglaway ang lion sa tao, magtanaw nga, lamian niyo eh, no pork chop ang tanaw niya sa tao. Wala pa ng klaseng appetite. Kundi ang ilang appetite is dahon, mukaog dahon, murag mga kabaw, no? Murag mga goat. Only after the flood. Genesis 9 is after the flood. After the flood, nga, everything was destroyed, nga naanay, commandment nga, nga i-allow na si Ginoo. Every moving thing shall, this is, God is talking to Noah, every moving thing that liveth shall be meat for you. Pwede na ka ito nagalihok, o mga hayop. Even as the green herb, pwede na po na mga prutas. Pwede na, i-allow. Sa una, first commandment sa Ginoo, naman kung yung tanaw, no, kanyang sa food, ganyang commandment, nag-usap-usap siya, may abot ang time, nga, bawal ang dugo, bawal ang baboy, na, i-allow na po ni Jesus kung makaon na yung baboy, may nana. But na-commandment ng Ginoo, nga kanyang kanyang pwede na mo mukaon. So this was the time nga, ang mga tao na sige naghantog mga food that includes the dinosaur. That includes the dinosaur. Oh, mo ning ganyan akong ingon. They hunt this maybe for food or maybe for the mammoth kanang ivory tusk sa elephant. So, i-ano nila, i-disable, and then kung ma-expose na ang heart sa kanila, mapatay. Dugay kayo na mapatay. Okay, now, another verse in the Bible talking about the behemoth. Ano sa man yung behemoth? Chapter 40, verse 16. Now, behold, behemoth, which I made along with you, he eats grass like ox. Na ay, gitawag ang, mingon siya kang Job. Behold, mutmurag pag ano ba nga, by the way, according sa mga kuan, ang Job was the oldest book, no? So, ingon niya, Job, behold, murag naara diha ba? Behold the behemoth. Ingon niya, now behold the behemoth which I made along with you. He eats grass like an ox. King. Grass yung ginakaon. What is this behemoth? Kanipot, another picture. Dili kay klaro kasi sa una pa ni 2005, di pa kayo high resolution ng pictures. But of course, you can recognize me. That is the Brachiosaurus, the biggest land dinosaur. Di, ganit ko kabot yata siyang tuhod. Di na ko mabot ng picture kaya yung ikog padong taas kanya. But you can see, kung inyo mong tanawin ang iyang ulo pa, taas kanyang liog, ana kadako ang Brachiosaurus. So, describes sa verse 16, see now, his strength is in his loins and his forces in the back. Ang iyang kusog na asa yung tiil ba? Dako yung tiil, massive kay. To be able to support his massive body, and yung muscle na siyang belly. No, dili, muliok siya, dako kayo. Another Let's continue. He hangs his tail like a cedar. The question is, namagimingon nga, ay, elepante man na, or hippopotamus. Ang iya bang tail sa elepante? Mura bag cedar? Pahing kag cedar tree, mention sa cedar tree in Bible, dagko na, muna ginahin mo, mga lumber, pang build o mga palas, no, palaces. Ara baka dako ang ikog sa elepante or
kwan?
So it does not talk about the elephant or the hippopotamus. It is talking about the apatosaurus ng mga dinosaurs. Okay, obviously. So it was called as behemoth kasi wala pa matunay inventong dinosaur, but it was called now a dinosaur. And then Leviathan chapter 41, maybe it is talking about the Kronosaurus. Okay? Now, how do you fit in dinosaurs into the Bible? Or maybe the question is, karon, natubag naman to, katong naa ang tao, possible kayo nga ang tao will survive, o ang tao will be the top of the food chain. Kasi the man was able to challenge the blue whale, mas ilang habitat. Men will be able to challenge dinosaurs as ano, the mammoth became extinct and other animals. The reason, kita ang bright, magut ang tao. We can put traps. We can do that, no? We always kanang find something. We are the top of the food chain, not this giant animal. Now, the question is, maybe di na to ma-reconcile. How do dinosaurs fit in the ark? Di po na to ni pwede nga ikuan nga. Nag-ingon si ang Ginoo nga, every animals. Of course, malilabo to mga isda, kaya mabuhi man sa sakuan. But every animals on earth, magdala ka og duha, babae og lalaki. That would include dinosaurs, but how would you fit in the Brachiosaurus? Okay. Kani magutanan na ay tubag. We don't have to change our point of view of the Bible to fit in sa konsay ginatudlo sa science. Na topic. So Noah, since na-register, kabulo na siya, bright na siya, nga di siya pwede mo dala og dagko nga hayop sa ark. Now, if we compare the size of the biggest dinosaur, ani kadako, ang actual ani murag ka ng murag bola sa football, ang chicken egg is anak kadako. So dili jud anak kadako ang kuan, ang egg sa dinosaur. But pasabot, they hatch small and then grow fast, became big. So with that, kung sino was 100 years old na, unsa yan dalon? Bata. Siguro kanang Brachiosaurus mo na kadakog elepante lang. Kay unsa may purpose nga magdala? Kay after the flood, they would reproduce. Kung magdala ka tigulang, pagkaman sa flood, mamatay lang. Dapat young o young adult. Di ba? So, why babies? Because they are smaller. The biggest dinosaur egg is the same size of a football. Okay? Ana lang kadako ang tali. Ano? So, kung mag-hatch siya, moro lang iring kadako ang tali. So, kung mudako-dako lang gamay, moro lang. So, kung pwede, the biggest na he could bring is kanang moro kadakag kabayo siguro. Okay? They weigh less. Of course, di dapat dagko. Ano mo dala magdagko? Gamay na po kagpakaunon, sigla na sa katulog kay mga bata o mga tough. Kaya mga bata, si kahulog. Ang buti nga, mutindog na magkapun, daga na po, dula na po, saka na po, ambag na po, no? Mga ligon. And after the flood, of course, they will produce more offspring compared to kung tigulang na andalon ni ano. Now, another thing is, where are the living dinosaurs? I have your picture, I'll not go through this, ano, na ay mga pictures din nga mga discoveries of mga bago lang, uban nga, bago rin namatay, sabot, anang just recently, mga months lang namatay, og ana, og kana, og daghang kana, obvious kayong ulo, wala kitaan ang animal, nana sa mga news, and then kanay, napicturan, na sa libro ni si Champ, ang even ang katong lake was named after these dinosaurs, and so on. And now, go to the second topic. Can I extend a little? Okay lang. So we talk about the time. How old is the universe? Is it billions of years? As what we know, is it less than 10,000? Is it 6 days or none of the above? Ninaas na mo to bag, tricky kayo. Ngayon sa ganun, wali ako answer. Okay, less, ha? Okay, less than 10. Okay, perfect ka sa akong klase. Kasama ka na ano. Now, this is actually the timeline of the creationist and the evolutionist. Ang timeline sa creationist is 6,000 years ago was the creation. That's according to the Bible. Let's do that. 4,400 years ago, there was a flood and the earth, birth of Jesus is year zero. That is why, atong date karon, atong year karon is 2024, it means 2,024 years ago was the birth of Jesus, di ba? That's the landmark. And ang evolution is time kay 20 billion years ago. And then ang earth forms around 4 billion years ago. Life appears around 3 billion years ago. And ang tao may ibigawas lang about 3 million BC. Nga may abot tong before siya naging unggoy, nahimo na sa tao. So, naay mga dinosaurs millions of years ago. This is the difference of the two. Now, going back to the question, how old is the earth? How would we know the age of the earth? Is it in the Bible that says, kupila ang edad sa kwan? Napainibutang the earth is 1 million years or 10,000 years, whatever. Can you see in the Bible? Nawala. Hindi na mutubag. Nawala. Ambot. Na! Asa na pa yung taon? Muna, matingala ako. Nabasa ba yung part sa Bible nga puro lang pangalan? Adam, bigat Seth, Seth, bigat ano. Na, at the age of 130, Adam, bigat Seth. Kani? Alam na. Musa may gamit ani? Nagibutang pa yung edad? Sample ha? Genesis 5:3. When Adam was 130 years old, na anak niya si Seth. Si Seth. Oh. When Seth was 105 years old, he became the father of Enosh. Na anang mga edad. So ibig sabihin, if we count that 130 plus 105 plus 90, we have here records from Adam to Abraham. We can find in Genesis. In Matthew also is from Abraham to David. And of course, we know, na natin written history, we know from David to Jesus. That's why we can know. And kung imo nang, okay, kanina, na di ako. Ay, nako, nabalik po. So kung imo itong i-add, dili siya muabot o, actually, siya muabot o 10,000 years old. Okay, and, muni siya, no? Muni kung ato na siyang i-total. Okay. Here, we can say that in the days of creation, earth was created on the first day, the earth, space, and light. The second is the atmosphere. Baga na itong atmosphere, no? Composed of nitrogen, carbon dioxide, and so on. The dry land and the plants in the third day. The sun and the moon and the stars is in the fourth day. The sea-flying creatures on the fifth day. And the land animals and men is on the sixth day. Kaya kung millions or thousands of years ang equivalent to one day, mamatay ang mga tanom kung pagpaabot pa sila maabot ang sun o ang moon. Okay? So it should be one day. Now, ang word nga day, kung atong tanawon sa Old Testament alone, it was mentioned 2,301 times. Why is it only in Genesis that we question the word day? Nga dili na siya literal nga 24 hours. Ganong diha lang because of the influence of evolution. Kung ato lang tanawon dito nga ang one day is equivalent to thousands of years, luoy kayo si Joshua. Kay gisugi, ano sa Ginoo nga libuti na og 6 days ang palibot, thousands of days na thousands of years. Kaya dili siya possible. Okay? Ngayon din ni, in 6 days I made the sky and the earth and the oceans and everything in them, but on the 7th day, klaro kay dinhi, I rested. That's why I made the Sabbath a special day that belongs to me. Again, it was mentioned in the Bible, it was created only on the sixth day. Okay, whatever the teaching that would contradict to this, dili na to dawaton. Kay mo man naging sa Biblia. Ngayon din eh, matuwa akong i-mention ganiya nga, pwede mo na, kwan bro, nga ang one day is equivalent to 1,000, sama sa kanina verse, no? Ngayon din eh, with the Lord, a day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is like a day. It doesn't say, a day is 1,000 days, but it is like a day, as the Lord is not slow in keeping His promise, as some understand slowness. It talks about the promise of God, not one day is equivalent to thousands of years. Mali siya nga interpretation. Now, there are numerous ways, scientific ways to show that the universe is not billions of years old. Kani, I received this actually, kung nato na pa mi sa bangkal, kani-kani yung census, population sa mga tao sa Pilipinas. Ang first census was done, I think, in 1903. And makita nyo, every year, nag-increase. In 2007, nahimo na siyang 88.6. In 1903, only 7 million of Filipino now living in the Philippines. Now, kung imo nang 88.6 divided by 7.8, pilaka-beses from 7 billion naging 88 million siya, pilaka-beses siya nag-increase. Ito na i-compute, 11.6 times siya nag-increase in a matter of 104 years. Kung imo ning i-multiply back, kung imo ning i-multiply by millions of years, mas millions of years lang, 300 millions of years sa ingon sa Biblia, pinakabuk tao sa Pilipinas, wala natin kabutangan ng tao. Okay? Yung ba din eh? Kaniha, bago lang ako na-research, morning every year, no? Na-i-debt per day, dini na lang ta sa per second. For, in every second, na ay, duha ka tao na matay, upat ka buok ang maanak, duha ka buok mamatay in every second. Last time I talk about this, it was 7 billion, karon abot na 8 billion ang tao. Okay. O kani, 8 billion na ang tao, muna ang source nga kong gikuan. Now, ingon din he, as according, kaya namatay data, pwede na ito makompute, no? Ingon din he nga, at this rate, the world population will double every 40 years. Okay? Double every 40 years. I-multiply niyo, butang lang ito, na ay pila ka tao dito sa tungkuan, after the Noah's Ark, I think there were 8, kauban ng ano, no? I-multiply niyo na into, every 40 years, multiply niyo na, og times 2, times 2, times 2, 40 years. I-multiply niyo na into billions of years, o millions of years lang. Walay kabutangan og tao. So, ibig sabihin, mali. Scientifically, mali siya. Ambot pasabot, in 3 million years alone, na ay 150,000 people per square inch. If we compute that, katong ilang gingon, according sa data ha, if we go back, reverse in time, sobra kayo, dili posible nga mag-ana yung kalayo ang kalibutan nga millions of years ago. But pwede siya, kung imo na compute, less than 10,000. According sa Bible, less than 10,000 ang ano. Another, the sun is shrinking actually. It is a scientific fact. The sun shrinks. Unsa na kadako? Gamay lang kaya tanawon, mura na siya o 0.1% each century, mo about 5 feet per hour. Paspas day. But since unsa kadako ang sun, na nag-decrease siya in size, walay problema sa 10 years o 10,000 years nga model, but kung imo nang i-compute, pabalik ni mo, o compute nga nagagamay ang sun karon, i-multiply ni mo ng 5 feet per hour, i-multiply ni mo into 3 billion, may laingon, 3 billion thousand years. Pwerte din nakuha ang adlaw sa unang panahon. So, dako ko itong problema na. Kaya kung dako ang adlaw, masi 50,000 years ago, wala. Mubukal lang ang tubig, 25,000 years ago, wala yung matanan, mag-barbecue. Kung anak ka dako ang adlaw, science na siya. Pero kung ang model na to around 10,000, masi pag nakadako ang sun sa una, dili yung anak ka dako. Bila kung millions of years or billions of years, that will be a problem. The sun will also absorb the Venus and Mercury. Katong dool sa iya ha. Tungkol sa kadako, ang gravity niya. Moon also. Ang moon daw nagpalayo of 2 inches per year. Kung imo nang i-reverse with millions of years, but pasabot ang moon, dool kayo sa Earth. Millions of years. Sa epekto, ana. Naman na epekto ng high tide, low tide sa moon. Madaot nga po ang Earth. Pero 10,000 of years, not ano, but naagay problema sa billions of years. Di niya possible according to the scientific data. What about the carbon dating? Carbon dating, let me explain. Muna po science teacher ani. Sa atong atmosphere is very thick, composed of nitrogen, carbon dioxide, o other elements. Ang composed of kanino, mostly is nitrogen, 21% oxygen, and then ay carbon dioxide. O kaning 0.000765% ang cardioactive carbon. Kaning carbon 14, mo ni ang gina-measure. Very, very little. Okay. Which combines with oxygen and mixes. And di atong one. Pongsano, so mo ni, ang carbon 14, which is, dili siya stable compared to na carbon 12, mo go back to sa atmosphere kasi unstable. So every, mura kitawag nila og kanang half-life kasi every 5,730 years, naali mabilin nga katunga sa carbon dioxide sa tao o sa hayop. Okay? And because of this, no, pagbuhi pa ang hayop, mukhaon siya og tanom, kaya ang tanom, naga-inhale siya og kanang carbon dioxide, naga-exhale siya og kanang oxygen, ang tao po, naga-inhale sa oxygen, naga-exhale po ng carbon dioxide, so na-exchange. And when they intake carbon dioxide sa lawas, ang kabayo, mukha o ano gano, na ay mabilin nga carbon 14 sa lawas. But after when they died, mag-release every 5,730 years, magkatunga na lang carbon 14. So na ay problema ani. Okay? Ato rin ang paspason. Kasi ani na siya, no? Every 5,007 years, katunga, and then maging 1/4, and naging 1/8, and naging 1/16. Mean to say, pag abot nag 40 to 50,000, wala na mabilin nga carbon. It's no longer measurable. So kanang dating ganin nila nga millions of years o 100,000 of years sa carbon, scientifically is wrong. Because carbon dating, you can only accurately read the carbon 14 in the kanang fossils up to 50,000 years or 40,000 years. So is how reliable is carbon dating? Gitest na sa kanang buhi nga kanang gitest na sa buhi nga kanang snail. Unsa iyang reading? 27,000 years old na daw ni nga kuan. Patay na din 27 years ago. Kani, buhi pa nga seal. 1,300 years ago ang kanang reading. 1971 nga no. Kaning mammoth, ang reading sa tiil kay 15,380 years, radiocarbon years. Ang iyang panit is 21,000. Namatay una ang iyang tiil, 4,000 years na bago namatay ang iyang panit. So, katawanan kayo ang mga reading. So, let me summarize. Nata sa itong end part, no? God made the world. Wala atik, no? Ang Ginoo, naghimo sa kalibutan. Siya ang tagiya. He makes the rules. Naa siya rules. Kung naay Ginoo, naa siya rules. Mao ang tao, di gusto mo to o Ginoo, kaya di sa gusto mo to o rules. And we are all guilty of breaking God's rules. That's the truth. The thing is, ang tao gusto mo yung Ginoo. Kaya walay ka ng, ano, walay, by this point of time, I would like to invite the music team to prepare. Iyon ni Hitler, I am God. Daka kong tao. Oh, I am God. I would conquer the world. I have many soldiers. Let's sum out more. I am God. Gamay di kay Hitler, I am God. Ano ba yung ano? Wala na. Di na makita si Hitler. And you know, wala na dyan. That is the Milky Way. And isa sa akong friend, nag-send sa akong email sa geology, doctor of geology siya. Pakita niya, compare the size of the planets. Compared to the smaller planets, compared to Pluto, Mercury, Mars, and Venus, dako ang Earth. Dako mo yun ang Earth. Wala pa kita kabot sa kato sa laing continent to, matravel tayo pila ka-oras, and so on. But Earth compared to other planets, okay? Earth. Ang Pluto mura nagdat. This is the Neptune. This is the Uranus. And dagko kayo ang Saturn. Asa na si Hitler? Hindi naman kita si Hitler dyan. And you say, I am God. But the Jupiter is not the biggest in planet in the universe, no? Na ay Sun. Sun actually is not a planet, it's a star. But this is not the biggest star. This is just a medium-sized star. Compare ni mo, di na makita at this point, di na makita halos ang Earth, no? Sun. And Sun compared to other stars, compared to this, ano ang Sun? Compared to this Arcturus or the Sirius or the Pollux, pertindakuan niya ng mga planets. Di pa ni pinakadako, ha? Napa? Asa ito ganiha? Murag din naman ito? Oh, Rigel, Aldebaran, Antares. Yung akong deserves karon, napay mas takuan to lang ani. This is how big the universe is. And how did God created this universe? He just spoke of the word. Wala niya gingunitan. But you know, even God created this vast universe walay lain nga living creatures in the known universe except Earth. And only in Earth, He came down from heaven to come here to die for us, to save us. He made all this creation nga nung naay adlaw para mabuhi ang mga tanom, naay bulan and everything for us because we are His beloved. We might think dako kay kong problema, dili man. Our God is big. We worship a huge, massive, enormous God. No, nothing can compare with His greatness or His bigness. No problem that kay cannot solve. Walay gamay, walay dako. May I invite everyone now to stand as we sing the song? I am the beloved. Do you have a slide on that? Okay, sige. Hallelujah. Lord, pasalo ami o God if we have a limited mind. Looking at things very small, okay, that tanan di o God compared to you. That is just nothing. We sometimes think, Lord God, nga wala ni makasolve sa problema. You, O God, who created the universe, even came on this earth to become human, become a servant, and offer your life to us. We pray that this time, Lord, forgive us and change our attitude, change our way of thinking. That you can do all things. That nothing is impossible to you. Every time we pray, nothing is too hard. Nothing is too small that you cannot see. Hallelujah. Let's sing the song, I Am Your Beloved.
Lord, it was you.
Yes, created the heavens. God of heavens, God of the universe, God of all creation, every knee will bow, every tongue will confess that you are Lord. Salamat, O God, because nothing is too hard, nothing is too difficult for you. You can do anything, Lord God. And whatever our concern karon, whether it is healing, whether it is about finances, na may utang na wala na bayaran, whether it is about relationships or your fear of something, God can answer. God can provide. God can heal. God can give you comfort. God can give you courage. Kung nagatubang ka mo na bigay kaluban ka ron. Salamat, O God, nga ikaw magatagbo sa tanan na mo pag-inahalanon. Ikaw, ginugalod, magkahatag ka na mo kusog, strength to face whatever challenges, whatever trials that we are facing now. Even I pray, O God, for these young people who are still studying, and when they encounter this kind of teaching, I pray nga, Lord, nga they will be smart enough na dili sila mabali, dili mag-falter ilang faith, but sila mismo, O God, Lord, know how to defend, because everything you have given us in the Bible is true, 100% correct. Salamat ginugan, Lord. To you we give all the glory and honor. Everybody will say, Amen.